Hello everyone and welcome to my YouTube channel. This is your movie guide and for today's episode, we are going to talk about a film that is currently on Philippine cinemas. And this film is called On Vodka, Beers, and Regrets starring Bella Padilla and JC Santos. So before we start our discussion, please don't forget to click the like and subscribe button down below so that you are updated with my latest uploads on this channel. So ladies and gentlemen, here goes our discussion with the movie entitled On Vodka, Beers, and Regrets. Kung hindi nyo pa po napapanood itong pelikulang to, I would suggest that you come back later to watch this because there will be some spoilers as we continue to discuss the film. But if you have already watched it, then please stay tuned and let's have a discussion. Please make your comments on the comment section below so that, you know, kung meron man akong nakalimutang mga pag-usapan, then doon nyo po ilagay kung ano yung inyong opinion about the film. Okay? Now, basically, the film is about a washed-up alcoholic actress who became actually an alcoholic at an early age. No, parang sa pagkakatanda ko, mga 9 years old yata, no, when she started drinking alcohol. And her father actually allowed it to happen. And yung alcohol daw kasi parang ang nagbibigay sa kanya ng lakas ng loob at saka makalimot sa mga masamang nangyayari sa kanya. And yun din yung nagbibigay sa kanya ng tamang emosyon, sabi niya, apparently, kung siya ay nakakainom. And unfortunately, no, when you take in too much alcohol, it becomes a disease already, some sort of addiction that, you know, it apparently carries on sa iyong career, okay, sa iyong relationships, okay? And here comes, of course, no, JC Santos, no, who plays the role of a rocker sa isang banda na hindi pa sumisikat o hindi na sumikat kasi nga matagal na silang tumutugtog at ang tanging way lang nila to survive is through gigs, no, to small gigs sa mga maliliit na bars. And what of course I like about this film is, you know, yung atake ng script. But because this film actually is different from the different love stories na, you know, mapapanood nyo with the other big productions, no? It isn't a film about a romantic love story na, you know, a boy meets a girl and, you know, they fell in love. And then magkakaroon ng a little conflict, okay? And then they resolve it afterwards, no, by, you know, getting back together, no, that kind of film is very formulaic. Now this film actually kakaibang atake niya kasi yung pagmamahal na gustong i-emphasize ng film nito is not really the romantic side of it but actually more of a concern for your loved one kasi well, nandoon yung mga elements of, you know, the meeting, okay, the getting to know together, okay? But unlike in the other, you know, formulaic films na ang sentro ay either selos or trabaho or pamilya na ayaw silang magkatuluyan, ito ang atake ng film na to is about the alcohol dependency of the character of Bella. And yun yung sentro nung yung romance na yun eh. Hindi nga romance actually. It's actually a concern for her to get well, to seek help. And actually, I think yun yung mga rare films na napapanood. I think this is the very first film actually na umatake o nagkwento about alcoholism. And it showed actually how it destroyed, you know, yung pamilya ni Bella, okay, and paano nasira yung career niya because of, you know, every time na nakakainom siya, at you know, when she wakes up in the morning, she does not remember what happened. Nagkakaroon ng blackout about her, you know, the night before, okay, nung ininom siya ng maraming alcohol. And you know, it's actually a very quiet film from the very start. Hindi maingay, hindi uso yung napapanood natin na sigawan. Hindi dito napapanood yung mga pelikula na, you know, yung kontrabida eh makikipagbangayan dun sa lead. Okay? Basta ano siya eh, it was really an intimate moment between these two characters na kahit simple yung kwento, simple yung plot, pero mai-invest ka doon sa emotions na ipinapakita ni Bella, okay, at saka ni JC. And it's wonderful actually to watch it kasi hindi ka nakakapanood ng mga ganitong movies eh. Parang tingin ko nga dapat magkaroon na ng upgrade in terms of, you know, how we should write films kasi nga there is an audience that would clamor ng mga ganito klaseng pelikula. Kaya, you know, if you have not really watched it, I would suggest that you go ahead, no, habang nasa sinihan pa yan. Baka by next Wednesday, wala na siya. So, yun. Panoorin nyo siya. I'm very sure na mag-e-enjoy pa rin kayo dito sa pelikulang ito. And ano pa bang gusto ko? Wala kasi akong personal na kakilalang tao na who became an alcoholic and who needs to have him or herself, you know, go to a place to have rehabilitation because, you know, alcoholism is, I think, no, parang considered dependency na rin kung sobra-sobra na yung pag-take natin. I feeling ko yung movie was well-researched kasi alam paano patakbuhin eh from point A to point B until dumating na doon sa point na talagang she was really out of control na and you know she was slightly incarcerated lang, no, for a destruction of property and then she realizes na oo nga mukhang kailangan ko na ng tulong kasi yung boyfriend ko nagsasabi na nahihirapan na siya and helpless na siya and hindi na niya malaman kung paano pa makakatulong. So ayun, I guess that is when you realize that, you know, you need help if the person you love actually is very concerned about your well-being. And you should get the help that you need. Although to be honest with you, hindi ko alam kung meron bang mga rehabilitation centers dito sa Pilipinas specifically for alcoholism kasi wala akong idea eh. Nabanggit lang doon sa movie meron sa Tagaytay. So kung meron man, I guess I feel like it should be made public. Kasi feeling ko kailangan ma-advertise 'yun eh. Kailangan malaman natin na meron pa lang mga taong tutulong sa mga ganitong klaseng kaso, no? Not just, you know, drug dependence but also alcohol dependence. So ayun, I really love this movie all through and through. Walang duda na, you know, their third or well, pangilan naman ito. Alam ko pangatlo na nila to together. Although magkasama sila doon sa Miracle at Cell Number 7, pero hindi sila love team eh. Sila eh, you know, they come from different places. Kaibigan ni JC si Aga doon sa pelikulang 'yon and anak ni Aga si Bella, no? So hindi sila love team doon. But this is, I think, their third film And every film that they made is actually, you know, mapangahas in the sense na they do not follow, you know, the typical love story na pinapakita sa film, no, na yung pinipilahan ng mga tao. I really, really recommend you to watch this film because, you know, may aral talaga kayong matututunan dito eh. So, ayun lang. And that's it, no? So, my rating for this film is 4.5 stars over 5. And that 0.5 probably, i-allow lang natin for some improvements on probably the lighting. You know, there were some scenes na maybe mas okay pagka liwanagan ng konti, no? Yung eksena. But other than that, you know, the story is written beautifully. Okay, the pacing is really not that slow. Tamang-tama, no, how it was developed, no, from start to finish. And that's it, you know. Go ahead and watch this film because hindi kayo magre-regret nito. So, again, this is your movie guide saying good night and see you at the movies.